Bring you through some import export workflows. Obviously, naming conventions is, you know, really important when working on these productions. There's going to be a lot of people pulling a lot of assets, a lot of different things into our project. So having some naming conventions is definitely the thing to you know, make sure the whole team understands. But here I have three different assets I'm gonna bring into Unreal for just to show you how the import settings work. We can pull in our static mesh, which is our S underscore studio pillar. Here we go. There's a lot of settings here. You don't have to worry too much about looking into all of them from the get-go. You'll notice usually if it's only a static mesh, it will not automatically be checked as a skeleton mesh. The reason it is, and I specifically did this so you can see why that happens, is it because there is a hierarchy within our static mesh where one object is the child of another object. I'm not exactly sure if you guys have a lot of experience with exporting or working in 3D softwares. If you don't, I'm not gonna do too big a deal out of it, but just make sure that if you only have a static mesh, you don't need to be a skeleton mesh, because it'll create a bone structure which you won't need, and etc. etc. So I'll uncheck that for now, because I know this is just a regular skeleton mesh. There's a couple of things I want to show you here. There's the most important ones, I think, is whether you want to combine the mesh or not. If it's all, because usually if you create a car, right, you'll have the chassis, you'll have four wheels, you'll have, you know, the undercarriage, there'll be a lot of parts that's not necessarily welded together in the 3D software. It will usually be several parts. But if this is unchecked, it will import all of those parts separately. So you'll get like 200 pieces within your folder that all are basically one piece of the car. So just make sure if you know it's all going to be combined, just check that. It'll pull it all together. It'll still be separate pieces, but it will be sort of in one asset. There's also a drop-down menu here that's called Import Normals. It should be default to import normals, but that's all about how your shaders are going to work, like how your surface of whatever asset you're bringing into Unreal is being handled. So usually we would do a proper normal adjustment in our 3D software. So import normals would be what you usually do. Compute normals means that basically the Pixotope or Unreal will try to create those surfaces by themselves, which sometimes can cause some issues because it won't necessarily understand which edges you want to be, you know, rough edges or hard edges, and which ones you want to be soft. Other than that, you can also choose whether you want to import materials as well. We'll do it for this one. It'll import the materials as well as the textures. We don't have any textures. It doesn't matter if you don't have them, whether or not it's checked. I'll uncheck it either way. So we'll bring this in. Here we go. So you see it brought in three different materials. And if I pull this into the scene, you'll see that this is why I combined them, because we have four different parts. So instead of having four different assets here, it combined them into one. I'll quickly walk you through the skeleton mesh and the animation as well, since you guys might be using those. We'll pull in our skeleton mesh. So now I'll leave the skeleton mesh checked. I have a couple of options here I want to show you as well. This use TOAs ref posts will, because if you don't set a specific bind post in your 3D software, it could cause some issues, but by checking this, it will use frame zero as your bind post. It's just good to check it if you don't have a specific bind post, because otherwise it could make it look kind of funky. So just make sure you check that. And then we have an option of importing animations if there are animations on your export or on your FBX file. And this is, we always try to keep them separate, so I'll make sure it's unchecked. To import it now, it should create three different assets. So it'll create our skeleton mesh, and it will create a physical asset. This is for collision purposes, and so if you want to have anything interacting with the object, it would need physics, and it will create the actual skeleton. And by double-clicking them, you can get a lot of extra information. But these are our actual bones in our skeleton, and our skeleton mesh is containing our whole asset, where we can adjust the materials and what you'll usually be accessing. So your skeleton is, it's what's going on sort of, you know, underneath the exterior of your, or the skin of your asset. Now I'll quickly show how to import an animation as well. Once you have your skeleton mesh in your scene, you can import an animation, and as long as that animation has the same bone hierarchy, it will automatically assume that you're trying to attach it to the skeleton with the same bone hierarchy. You can choose another one if you have several ones that you want to attach it to, or if you have two skeleton meshes that has the same bone hierarchy but has a different look or a different mesh, for instance, you might want to do that. But yeah, just make sure it's the correct skeleton, and then you can import that. And now I can bring these into our scene, or I can double click it as well, and you can see it'll play our animation. So yeah, it's pretty straightforward when importing and exporting, as long as you kind of just do a quick overview of your checks when you're importing, and that should be fine.